The battle between left-wing councils and the government's been raging for months, but today the boroughs believe they've won. Out goes compulsory tendering for key services like refuse collection, street cleaning and school meals. Out goes propaganda on the rates, where council cash is used to highlight local objections to government policy. And out too goes an end to what the government calls unreasonable contract conditions. This could mean firms pledging no links with South Africa or with Rupert Murdoch's whopping plant before being allowed to work for some left-wing councils. After the announcement, the Association of London Authorities, which represents Labour boroughs, claimed a major victory. But the minister warned these plans have only been shelved.
They haven't been abandoned. They're going to come in a little bit later than we'd hoped, that's all. Either before or after the next election, we will proceed with these clauses. What this bill does is to make illegal some of those devices whereby the Labour Party's councils have been borrowing very large sums of money, which in the end the ratepayers will have to pay back.
It's a massive political climb down. The right-wing Secretary of State for the Environment abandoning three important planks in his policy of attacking local government, policies which were apparently so necessary as recently as 2 weeks ago.
The Boilermakers Union, which represents 25,000 local government workers, is today also claiming a massive victory. But the minister warns future action will be taken against Labour boroughs, which he calls a menace to our society. Julie Clive for Thames News.